Hi everyone, we are Marfa Machado, María Elena Marín, and myself, Christian Espinosa. We are going to present you the synthesis about our part of this unit of research. Specifically, our topic is going to be case study in education contest, so we hope you enjoy it. Thank you. Case study has some key elements that will help us to frame the research and also to get better understanding about the phenomenon that we are observing. One of the key elements is that the case study is considered as a genre of research that is a way of framing a particularity. This is selecting specifically the phenomenon we want to observe. To have this particularity clearly defined, we need to set a bounded unit. The bounded unit makes reference to the group that we are analyzing, either if it is a group of students or a group of teachers. This group, or the observation that we are going to do over the group, shouldn't be separated from the community. It means that the researcher needs to put in practice a personal and professional perspective to analyze the relationships between the members of the group, of the bounded unit, and its community. This study involves some interactions, communications, relationships, and practices between the case, it means the group, and a wider world. So this makes reference to the community. The case study is focused also in collecting data. They recommend two ways of collecting data. One is through a short, intensive period of time, or the other way is more longitudinal, that is on a longer period of time, where they recommend to be patient and as a researcher, and also being able to adapt to the changes of the environment. When presenting results of the case study, they recommend to give at least two perspectives or two points of view how we approach to the phenomenon observed, and minimum two ways of or two variety of data collection. It means that we need to present either interviews or records or results or notes from an observation. Robert Stake makes a distinction between two types of case study. The first one is the intrinsic case study that is related to capturing the case in its entirety. The purpose of this type of case study is to understand more fully the entity that makes up the case, it means the researcher. The other type of case study is the instrumental case that is more focused on one single aspect or issue about the case. It means that it could be related, for example, about a teaching or learning process or an implementation of a methodology or curriculum development or issues of personal and professional relevance.
There are other models besides the intrinsic and instrumental. These are the reflective, longitudinal, collaborative, collective, and cumulative models, which are research processes that can help in education settings. The reflective model can be introspective because it focuses on the own practice of the researcher. This is that the researcher is the central point of research and the research is emphasizing the data collected by him or she. And this data can be experiences, feelings, reflections, etc. With this model, different kinds of evidence are built and it can be conducted for a short period of time. On the contrary of the reflective model, the longitudinal model is conducted for a longer period of time because it is important to understand a process and it's not focused on static data but dynamic. It pretends to analyze processes and changes and link the present, past, and future. The collaborative, collective, and cumulative models are similar in some aspects. The first, they rely on case studies generated from the same theme of research. Their strength lies in the building of data which enrich the case study with evidence from different social contexts, pupils, parents, and teachers. And finally, their combination provides help to draw conclusions better grounded. Regardless, there are similarities, there are some differences. In the collective model, the researcher works independently and asynchronously. But in the collaborative model, the researcher works in conjunction with colleagues or institutions with a similar purpose, which is to generate substantial evidence in different contexts. And the cumulative model replicates and or develops existing case studies with the purpose of collecting more evidence to draw conclusions on a particular phenomenon or development.